is this really worth it? Do I really need to put my worth and put so much attention into my hair? How's it going, everyone? And welcome to this video. In this one, I'm going to be explaining why I do not take finasteride, do not take Propecia, and why, really, I never even considered it. These are my five reasons why I don't take Propecia. Reason number one, I present to you Exhibit A. Propecia reduces the amount of DHT in your body. There might be some guys out there thinking, wow, that's fantastic, because it's that nasty little DHT that clings on, acts around here with our hair follicles, and makes our hair poo fall out. But I now present you Exhibit B. It's that very DHT that is responsible for our male characteristics. In a nutshell, the DHT makes us men, right? It gives us those manly qualities. And if we think about this, right, as a common sense approach, we're no better than those damn little monkeys, right? What am I talking about here? If we strip away all of the things that, you know, modern man has created that we concern ourselves with, if we take that all away and we go to our basic animal instincts, we're driven to reproduce, right? We're driven. We want to reproduce our genes. We want to get our genes, pass them on, get them out there. Fuck me. We want our genes to live on, right? And it's that DHT, it's that testosterone that gives us that drive that we need in life to be successful. You see, now if we put that in today's world, right? Why do you want a good job? You want a good job so you can be successful, so you can have money, you can have less worries, right? Have a better mind, a better body, a better spirit. You're going to attract a partner that way, and you're going to be able to reproduce. And if you take that drive away, if you take that DHT, you take that manliness away from you, you're going to start having problems. But it's that DHT that makes us men, and why the hell am I going to want to go ahead and mess with that? And that brings me on nicely to reason number three, the side effects. The risk of these side effects is the biggest reason why I will never, ever take Propecia. So what side effects are we talking about? Well, I want to share with you a few clips here from guys on YouTube talking about their own side effects from Propecia.
However, he wasn't prepared for the extreme side effects. They left him practically impotent, shrunk his penis, and left him depressed and suicidal.
It started with the onset of insomnia where I didn't sleep for about a week. When I was trying to be intimate with Hayley, I was practically impotent.
And it's a complete erectile dysfunction.
Yeah, absolutely.
He says it made him slip into a mental fog, it made him impotent, and even shrank his genitals.
And I noticed my body wasn't responding correctly, and then when it was a time for sex, I noticed things weren't responding properly either.
Now, I was blown away by that when I looked into this, and I was listening to these stories, and, you know, one of those little side effects, the slightest risk of it, absolutely not. I cannot understand why guys are going to risk the very thing that sort of drives them, the reason why they're on this planet, that influences all of their other decisions. I just can't understand why anyone is going to run the risk of messing with that. And now there might be people out there thinking, hey, look, the chances of getting these side effects are so small. Hey, don't take it from me. Why don't we listen to a little doctor? Let's see what the doctor has to say about the risk of getting these side effects, the chances.
The downside, what about side effects? Well, the studies were done on 18,000 patients, so huge numbers here. So the statistics are valid. The side effect rate was about 5% or less. That's pretty generous. It's probably about half of that. The most notable side effect was sexual dysfunction. So guys complained of decreased libido, trouble getting erections, that sort of thing.
So he said there, the study said 5%. He said it's probably more like 2.5% of the 18,000 men. Well, 2.5% of 18,000 men. That's 450 guys. 450 people. Now, you can bet your bottom dollar that there is more than 18,000 men out there using that finasteride at the moment. And that is a staggering amount. Even if it was 1%, that's still a huge amount, a huge chance that you might just experience some of these side effects. Now, let's get on to my reason number four. Reason number four is because, again, right, it's not a cure. What if there comes a day when you decide not to take it anymore? Well, what, you know what's going to happen, don't you? That hair is going to fall out, and you're going to be reverted back to the hair that you would have had if you never started, aka you're going to go back to being bald. And so for that very reason, right, you're taking this Propecia and you're holding on to that hair. You're keeping it going, right? It keeps the existing hair. That's why, hey, they say, oh, you've got to start early. The earlier, the better. Act fast and you can save more of your hair because it allows you to hold on to the hair you have. It's very unlikely that you're going to regrow a lot of hair, okay? You might regrow some, but not to the extent where you've got a beautiful, luscious locks of hair. The main thing it's going to do is going to allow you to keep on to the hair that you have at that time. And guys, we've talked about the mental side effects of all of this. You're going to become dependent on that Propecia. And this is why I didn't want to take it. I'm going to be popping that pill, holding onto my hair, thinking, oh God, if I don't have this pill, my hair is going to fall out. You become dependent on it, dependent on that little pill. And that mentally is really going to start messing with you, okay? Because again, you're not your true self. You're relying on this external pill that you have to take to hold onto that hair. That is just not a healthy mind frame, mindset to be in. It's gonna, again, gonna chain reaction, lots and lots of problems just because of that little pill, and you gotta keep eating it to hold onto that hair. It's gonna create fear, it's gonna create anxiety. It's just gonna create a whole lot of psychological side effects. Now, reason number five, again, this one, it's a big one, guys, it's cost. I didn't realize how damn expensive this finasteride, this Propecia was, right? I've seen guys say that you can get 3 months of this stuff for £90. That's £360 in a year. If you're looking at 5-6 years taking this stuff, that's the same amount as a hair transplant over in Turkey there. You can also get it online for something like £45 a month, which is a bit more common. And again, over 5-6 years, the same amount as a hair transplant. So expensive, we're talking thousands of pounds here. And if you're going to be on this stuff for life, then the cost is just ridiculous. And then that shocked me even more to know that guys are spending thousands on a hair transplant, then thousands on things like Propecia and Rogaine, often those two things combined to put onto that head after the hair transplant. Oh, and this just shocked me so much to see the amount of money that guys are spending just to hold onto that hair. It absolutely blew me away, literally spending tens of thousands of pounds, tens of thousands of dollars. Money that they can do so much good with. Like we've said before, invest in yourself, invest in growing yourself, finding that intrinsic, internal motivation to just be successful in so many ways rather than spending it just on something like your appearance. Oh, so there you have it, guys. This really, really shocked me to learn about these side effects, just how common these side effects are, just how unbelievable. I mean, we're talking about your penis shrinking. We're talking about you can't even get hard on, right? And so what the hell, like, I've mentioned this in a previous video. Look at this chain reaction here, right? You're motivated to hold onto your hair because you want to look good. Why do you want to look good? You want to look good because you want to be successful and you want to attract a mate. So you're putting all your worth in looks here, right? You think that's going to be the important thing to attract this female, male, whatever. Let's just say female. We go on to the next stage, okay? You've taken this pill and now you run the risk. Let's just say you are one of that 2.5%. Now you can't get your dick hard. It doesn't work. You've got mental side, psychological side effects. So the very reason why you wanted to take that pill is now irrelevant because you can't even do the thing you're motivated to do, which is reproduce, have sex, right? Be virile, enjoy yourself, be motivated, be rrr. You can't even do that anymore. So you come off it. Well, now you've got this post-finasteride syndrome. Those side effects carry on. They may even get worse. And not only that, because you've stopped, your hair's going to fall out. And guys, this could ruin lives, right? You're going to be way worse off than if you've just thought about it hard, thought about it long and hard, thought, is this really worth it? Do I really need to put my worth and put so much attention into my hair? Or am I better than that? Do I have other things that I can use to create success, to attract a partner? I really encourage you out there, if you're thinking about taking this propecia stuff. Look long and hard, right? Really, really consider it, because this has the potential to leave you far worse off than if you'd have just been losing your hair, or if you were just bald like me. So guys, those are my reasons why I don't take propecia. I think it's dangerous stuff. It really terrifies me that guys are out there willing to even risk their sexual health for the fact that they can hold on to their hair. I know this video isn't going to sit well with everyone, especially guys that take it and they say, hey, I take it, no problems. So, hey, there's guys that take steroids that have no problems, right? But there's also people that do drugs who end up dead, end up depressed, and with dicks that don't work. And at the end of the day, guys, I just think it isn't worth it just to hold on to that hair. Life can be fun. Life can be happy. You can be successful. Things can be fantastic without hair. You don't need drugs. You just need to keep an open mind, stay positive, know that you can get through it and come out the other side happy, loving life. Guys, I want to thank you so much for watching this video. I know it was a little bit ranty, but you know, this whole propecia thing, kind of the more research I did, really got me kind of riled up, okay? And it just made me realize that what I'm trying to do here, show people the positivity that can come through dealing with hair loss, how I think is the right way to deal with it, by accepting it, shaving off that thin hair, getting on with it. Really, wow. I mean, my eyes were wide open to this. I was gobsmacked. Anyway, I want to thank you so much for watching. If you're new here to the channel, make sure you check out my other videos like this one, and subscribe if you think, hey, this stuff looks interesting. Guys, thanks again for watching. I will be back very soon with another video. Goodbye.